Welcome to Morning Prayer with St. James Cathedral. My name is Claire, and we will be celebrating the feast day of Hugh, the Bishop of Lincoln, who's a 12th century bishop, who was also a Carthusian monk. And we will be using the service in the Book of Alternative Services, and we'll start on page 46. He shall blossom as the lily and strike root as the poplar. His beauty shall be like the olive trees and his fragrance like the cedars. Let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon us, pardon and deliver us from all our sins, confirm and strengthen us in all goodness, and keep us in eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Alleluia. The Lord is glorious in his saints. O come, let us worship. Let's say the Jubilate. Be joyful in the Lord, all you lands. Serve the Lord with gladness, and come before his presence with a song. Know this, the Lord himself is God. He himself has made us, and we are his. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter his gates with thanksgiving. Go into his courts with praise. Give thanks to him and call upon his name. For the Lord is good. His mercy is everlasting, and his faithfulness endures from age to age. The Lord is glorious in his saints. O come, let us worship. A psalm appointed for Hugh's feast day is Psalm 112, which is found on page 860 of the BAS. Hallelujah. Happy are they who fear the Lord and have great delight in his commandments. Their descendants will be mighty in the land. The generation of the upright will be blessed. Wealth and riches will be in their house, and their righteousness will last forever. Light shines in the darkness for the upright. The righteous are merciful and full of compassion. It is good for them to be generous in lending and to manage their affairs with justice. For they will never be shaken. The righteous will be kept in everlasting remembrance. They will not be afraid of any evil rumors. Their heart is right. They put their trust in the Lord. Their heart is established and will not shrink until they see their desire upon their enemies. They have given freely to the poor, and their righteousness stands fast forever. They will hold up their head with honor. The wicked will see it and be angry. They will gnash their teeth and pine away. The desires of the wicked will perish. God of light, teach us to love each other as you love us, that we may bring peace and joy to the world and rejoice in the kingdom of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. The reading is found in Paul's letter to the Ephesians, chapter 4, verses 1 through 16. I, therefore, the prisoner in the Lord, beg you to lead a life worthy of the calling to which you have been called, with all humility and gentleness, with patience, bearing with one another in love, making every effort to maintain the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, just as you were called to the one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. But each of us was given grace according to the measure of Christ's gift. Therefore it is said, when he ascended on high, he made captivity itself a captive. He gave gifts to his people. When it says he ascended, what does it mean but that he also descended into the lower parts of the earth? He who descended is the same one who ascended far above the heavens, so that he might fill all things. The gifts he gave were that some would be apostles, some prophets, some evangelists, some pastors and teachers, to equip the saints for the work of ministry, for building up the body of Christ, until all of us come to the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God, to maturity, to the measure of the full stature of Christ. We must no longer be children tossed to and fro and blown about by every wind of doctrine, by people's trickery, by their craftiness in deceitful scheming. But speaking the truth in love, we must grow up in every way into him who is the head, into Christ, from whom the whole body, joined and knit together by every ligament with which it is equipped, as each part is working properly, promotes the body's growth in building itself up in love. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. I thought I would read just a short section from Hugh's biography. He apparently was not a very well-known sermonizer. And he didn't write any books, or he wasn't particularly learned in that way, but he was known for being just a very gentle and wonderful man. So this is a reading from The Life of St. Hugh by Adam of Aynsham. It was written in the early 13th century. Among all the other evidence of Hugh's Christian love, who can do justice to the care he devoted to the sick or to the tenderness he displayed even towards those wasted with leprosy? On lepers especially, he lavished alms, besides refreshing them with food and drink, and he would often wash and dry their feet with his own hands and caress them with kisses. He used to do this to 13 lepers at a time, as often as that many could be found where he was staying, in the privacy of his own apartment with a few witnesses present. On some of his episcopal estates, there were hospices where not a few who suffered from this disease, both men and women, were maintained. He gave various kinds of aid and comfort to these lepers, beyond what his predecessors had allotted for their upkeep. With a small number of his reverent and pious retainers, he frequently paid calls on these people and, taking his seat among them in a small, out-of-the-way room, he would lift their spirits with words of hope and relieve their sorrows with a mother's gentleness, as he encouraged those who were wasted and afflicted in this present age to hope for an eternal reward. So now turning back in the Book of Alternative Services to the Apostles' Creed, which is on page 52. Let's say together, I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Pray with confidence to the Lord, saying, Lord, hear our prayer. O Lord, guard and direct your church in the way of unity, service, and praise. Lord, hear our prayer. Give to all nations an awareness of the unity of the human family. Lord, hear our prayer. Cleanse our hearts of prejudice and selfishness, and inspire us to hunger and thirst for what is right. Lord, hear our prayer. Teach us to use your creation for your greater praise, that all may share the good things you provide. Lord, hear our prayer. Strengthen all those who give their energy or skill for the healing of those who are sick, in body or in mind. Lord, hear our prayer. Set free all who are bound by fear and despair. Lord, hear our prayer. Grant a peaceful end and eternal rest to all who are dying, and your comfort those who mourn. Lord, hear our prayer. Holy God, who endowed Hugh of Lincoln with boldness before sovereigns and humility in serving his flock, grant that we also, rejoicing in your mercy and fearing nothing but the loss of you, may be bold to speak the truth in love. Through Jesus Christ, our Redeemer, who is alive and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. May the God of hope fill us with all joy and peace in believing through the power of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Peace of Christ.